We have a huge change that is right around the corner as we go into next week and beyond, everybody. This will impact the U.S., Canada, including Europe. This is going to bring back strong weather patterns, also a lot of snowstorms, and maybe some very cold polar air. Right now, as sure as you're watching this video, we are getting a sudden stratospheric warming event. Now, this takes about 10 days for it to hit the ground level and impacting everyone else. Now, this is happening way up into our stratosphere where our polar vortex is breaking down. And this will bring multiple vortices coming into the U.S. and Canada, bringing multiple very strong storms, possibly big snowstorms, especially as we go into December. December is going to be a big cold event with a lot of snow because of the event that we're going into now. Now, this is going to bring strong storms, especially as we go into our Thanksgiving week. And then in December, when it starts dropping that very cold polar air, this is going to bring potentially a big white Christmas for a lot of people as we get a lot of snow coming in and very cold air. So I'm going to go through the weather pattern so you know exactly when and where this is happening and what to expect. Now, you can see this in the data. The data always shows what's coming around the corner. And you can see this in your EPO, your East Pacific Oscillation, what your jet stream is doing on the west coast of the United States. Now, you see we have this trough sticking through all the way towards Friday and Saturday. This is along the west coast. It's going to be a long atmospheric river, still bringing a lot of flooding. Then we're going to have two more that's going to kick in after that. This is going to be a little northern in the northwest, but more storms coming along the west coast. Now, as we go into the 20s of November, go past Thanksgiving, going all the way into the very beginning of December, we're going to a big negative EPO and potentially going way negative. This is going to bring our jet stream way far to the south on the western U.S., going up on a high ridge, just like I showed you in yesterday's video. Now, you see this when you look way up into the atmosphere, about 10 to 30 miles. And what you can see is, you can see all this blocking coming from this stratospheric warming event, and you see it come across. Now, when it comes across, it becomes a major event, and it changes the directions of our winds. This is going all the way past Thanksgiving. This is when we're getting a very deep EPO over here and bringing a lot of storms. Now, this is going to last all the way into December. And in December, all this very cold bottled up air is going to come crashing on in. So in December, we're going to see a lot of Arctic blasts coming through. We're going to see a lot of heavy snowstorms come through and potentially a lot of severe weather as well because of that temperature gradient, potentially ice storms and severe weather and major snowstorms all at the same time. So you see the first half of it with our storms, and this is our vorticity. It shows this rotation in the atmosphere. And you see how you get a strong storm over here. We still have two over here for California, but mostly for Washington and Oregon on this vortice as this goes up towards the north. And then we're going to get that deep trough still coming down. You can see that jet stream coming way down south. It's going to come even lower, everybody. So as we go forward for today, for tomorrow, it sits there for Friday. Then this first piece still goes up towards Manitoba, towards Ontario, even Quebec, bringing a big snowstorm from people in Canada. But this jet stream keeps going deeper and deeper while this sits here all the way till Saturday and Sunday, bringing a big flooding threat at the same time. Now, when that storm system comes from Canada and swings across for the northeast, still bringing storms for y'all. You do have a day for severe weather. We need to watch out for it. It's bringing damage of winds. Then you're going to get that freezing rain and that snow that's still going to happen as you go Saturday into Sunday. But remember, this jet stream deepens all the way into the 20s. So watch right here and you'll see the jet stream just looking like a subtropical jet, just going lower and lower and lower all the way until the 18th. Then it's going to swing in storms. It's going to come in from the west, going that higher ridge still towards the Midwest and the north. And we're going to get storm after storm after storm. So what we have first, we have for today, we have the storms hitting for California. You can see this happening for this morning, still going down central California by time the afternoon. You even get some storms from the other shortwave trough into Washington. Then it goes further down California. Remember, it sits till Saturday, now for tomorrow. Plus, you're going to get snow in higher elevations. For tomorrow, it's going to pivot towards Southern California, and then it's going to pivot towards Arizona a little bit with Nevada as well as you go into Saturday. Saturday is going to be another big day. It's just going to sit here all the way until Saturday, bringing a lot of rainfall. Then you're going to get the storms coming across for Saturday for the northeast, bringing that chance for severe weather and still bringing that freezing rain and that snow for the northern half of New England. And you can see this here as you go into Saturday evening. You start to get some strong banding that comes out from this front, and it could bring chances for damage and winds to come across as it comes by for later into the evening. This happens from 6 all the way towards 8 and 9 o'clock at night, maybe even a little bit longer for West Virginia. But then it starts changing over towards freezing rain in that red and snow in that blue as you go overnight Saturday into Sunday. For upstate New York, Vermont, New Hampshire, and Maine, even some of Massachusetts getting in on that freezing rain. Showing is going to be a mix. You're going to be a mix of some sleet, maybe even a quarter inch, maybe even some people getting a half an inch of sleet. It all depends on the temperature gradient, and some of that is going to be freezing rain. But also showing is bringing major snowfall as well, mostly for upstate New York, Vermont, New Hampshire, and some of Maine. And you can see this from National Weather Service as you go into Saturday. You have a 5% risk for severe weather. So far, here's your cities and states at risk for that. Now, this is going to add up on this atmospheric river and keep you in a slight risk for heavier rainfall, and you're still going to get that precipitation across the northeast for the next 4 days. This is all the way for Saturday night into Sunday morning. And for the northeast, you actually could see 1 or 2 inches of rainfall for central and western New York. That could be the heaviest spot. Everyone else is looking about a quarter inch to a half an inch of rainfall. So you can see here on the rainfall rates for the next 4 days, northwestern Montana getting 2 or 3 inches, also northern Idaho going into Canada, western Canada getting a lot of heavy rainfall, as well as Washington. This is anywhere from 2 to 4 inches. Plus California getting very heavy rainfall. You're going to be the heaviest rainfall across the whole country. Look at this, getting anywhere from 2 to 3, 2 to 4 inches, and the higher elevations getting anywhere from 4 to 5 inches. Even Southern California is going to feel this flooding issue. And this is bringing a lot of snowfall, especially over here for Canada, northern half of Washington, Idaho, and Montana. But the higher elevations in California, you could see anywhere from 3 to 4 feet of snow. So you have your flooding risk naturally. So for today, you do have a marginal for flash flooded for Washington. And you can see over here for California, you have the marginal. You also have the slight risk. This is going to bring heavier flooding, so be aware of this. And this is going to last a couple to a few days. For tomorrow, you're going to have it again for central to southern California. And you have a slight risk as well for the flash flooding. So be aware, this is going to go down central, even southern California. As you go into Saturday, this is where it sits here for quite some time, and you actually have a big area for flash flooding. So make sure you're aware if they have sandbags out. I did see there are stations that are posting them. Please go get them and get ready for the flash flooding, especially if you're in a flood-prone area. Now, after this passes by, as we go into Wednesday, we're going to start coming across another chance for severe weather. Matter of fact, multiple chances for severe weather. It's going to bring a lot of storms, everybody. So as we go into Thursday, we're going to have this low pressure building, chances for severe weather over here across the south and the south central, and we're going to be multiple storms. This is only storm number one. Now this is going to move out by Thursday and Friday and go towards the Great Lakes, bringing a chance for more severe weather, everybody. This is going to bring chances for damaging winds, hail, even chances for tornadoes, especially with that tail whip. Now as we go from Friday into Saturday, this is going to move towards Canada, even bring some severe weather potentially towards interior northeast, while we get another storm system building up for Saturday, and it's going to be rinse and repeat. This is going to be one after the other because of a strong weather pattern that we're going into, everybody. And this is a set event. It is locked in. It is trending with the weather models, and you can see it here on precipitation. As we go from Wednesday on with those storms coming through, it's bringing a big area, just a set area, where you're going to get a lot of heavy rainfall. It's going to bring flooding, but this is where you're going to get your severe weather and your storms as well. Now, when you compare this to GFS, you can see the same thing that is showing, that you're going to get a lot of storms coming through, bringing all that flooding. Not to mention all this heavy rainfall coming across the Four Corners and the Southwest. Showing damaging winds is going to be coming across with those storms as well. And this is with the Euro. You can also see this with GFS. showing it's bringing some strong damage and winds as well. This is going to move around a little bit, but it's pretty much that set phase I showed you yesterday. A big deep trough going to that high ridge, and all this orange is 50 miles per hour wind gusts. Very strong storms that's going to be coming through pretty soon, especially for Thanksgiving. So when you all going to be traveling for Thanksgiving, you need to watch out for where these storms are going to be. We even have an outlook already for the 20th through the 26th for heavy precipitation to come through, and a moderate section over here in this darker green. And still showing as we go into December, these storms are going to continue and bring a lot of heavy snow, potentially multiple inches, major snowstorms coming through. Now remember, with all this very heavy snow is going to come some strong storms as well. So on the southern half, we're going to see a lot of severe weather, while on the northern half, we're going to see a lot of cold hits from the polar vortex and a lot of major snow. And I'd like to share with you some images that my wife got last night of the auroras that hit last night. Very beautiful picture. She did a great job. Look at that color. That is a bright green. And thank you to everybody that showed support. Make sure you go to the link in the description. Get you some of that holiday cheer promotion. Get you a candle, get you a mug, even get you a Weatherman Plus hoodie. And thank you for everyone that has showed support. I greatly appreciate you, and my family really appreciates you. Thank you so much. And that is your weather forecast, everyone. So thank you again for your time. Hope you have a very blessed day today. Do like the video. Make sure you subscribe for updates. Make sure you share this to other people. Let them know what's coming around the corner. And before I go, a quick word from our Father, everybody. Philippians 4, 6 through 9. Remember, there's so much fake news out there, so much hate. Remember these words. Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God. And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, and if there be any praise, think on these things. Those things which ye have both learned and received and heard and seen in me, do, and the God of peace shall be with you. Amen. And just so you know, that was Paul speaking. Remember, everybody, all glory does go to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life. And forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. Get ready for this big change.